across the estate. I was asked to host this show.
It's about Jacko and his quest to destroy life as we know it. Everyone in the game is based on someone I know.
Kid, where are you?
That's me.
I can't make it stop! It's reading the game!
Why is it reading the game?
The Cold Steel Kid, as I live and breathe. Which son of a gun I'm doing, aren't I?
If you get past this level, you'll still have your hands full with the others.
Thinking?
Maybe.
I was thinking about that tiny black dress I bought you for my birthday. Whatever happened to that tiny black dress?
You tore it to shreds getting it off me.
Ah, yes. The cruise to Acapulco.
The motion of the ocean.
The smell of the salt air.
The shredding of the dress. Guess I'm gonna try and get some sleep.
Yeah, me too.
Good night.
You need a mechanic there, buddy?
Yeah. Hey, are you guys from the auto club?
My dear fellow, consider this merely the compassionate gesture of a compassionate man.
Hey, how come you got your rearview mirror all taped up?
Oh, Mr. Logan is a bit insecure about his appearance, though. Between you and me, I consider him a heartbreaker.
You got yourself a cracked radiator, your alternator shot. And you got a leaky carburetor.
Hey, I just called because I ran out of gas.
Yeah, well, that's the way it always starts. You just give me a minute, I'll work up an estimate for you.
No, 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 forget the estimate. I just need some gas.
When I'm in a situation like this, which, frankly, I never am, I recall those words of wisdom uttered by a great mind. Mine. Never question a man armed with power tools.
I got that estimate for you.
I start CPR, but my hands are full. Like I said, he's a heartbreaker.
We'll be right back.
It has 12 cylinders, 492 horsepower, and one antifreeze coolant to protect it all. Xerex. And now Xerex comes in an easy carry 3-pack, the perfect amount for the 2-car family. Today's engines are made for Xerex.
There's an exciting new world out there, and one company is helping you put it all within your reach.
Now's a great time to be alive. The world is moving to a brilliant sun. Now is a great time for man, woman, child. I tell you, children, I tell you something. Listen, people, I tell you something. My human family, I tell you truth.
It's all within your reach.
That's your true choice. AT&T.
Sorry to pull you out of bed for this, sir. Captain insisted we call you in on this one.
Yeah, well, stolen tires seem to be my specialty. Ever since I started seeing the captain's ex-wife, she's using her maiden name. How was I to know?
Emmy did a preliminary. There's no trauma, no wounds of any kind. Thinks the guy may have had a heart attack.
It must have been really nice tires.
Mr. Toshiro. This is Mr. Toshiro. He was driving by when he saw the victim.
I called 911 on my cell phone, but you know it was too late. He's got to be what, 40?
38.
38? I'm 38. Why would a guy have a heart attack at 38?
Six words. Are you gonna eat those fries? Did you see anybody driving away from the area? Anybody in a hurry, maybe with four tires in the back seat?
The streets were pretty empty, but I did see a couple guys in a white Chrysler ahead of me. I'm getting a treadmill.
This white Chrysler, describe it.
I don't know. It was just this beautiful, classic Chrysler.
Guy in a white suit driving it?
Yeah. How do you know?
I took a course in ESP. Got an A. Of course, I knew I was going to get an A. Dress? I thought...
Yeah, a few stitches here and there. Never know it was torn. Unless you look, real close.
What do you know? You're right.
Whatever you do?
Mm-hmm.
Don't pull it.
What happens when I pull?
Unspeakable things.
Who is that?
It's me. Bad news. We're back in play.
It's 100 degrees, Cass. Why can't Jackal just sit in front of an air conditioner like the rest of the city?
You're wet.
Hannah's taking a shower.
Have your clothes on?
I was also doing laundry. Are we at least going someplace cold?
No, sorry. It's Ross Logan. He's a car mechanic I used in high school. Or actually, he used me.
Grow up, Gus.
We were married. It's nothing I haven't seen before.
Seen what?
Mechanics who take advantage of their customers. It's despicable.
What's our marriage got to do with it?
Look, the point is, Logan was supposed to fix my brakes, and he didn't. And because he didn't, I wrecked my very first car.
Oh, no. Not the Gus Lloyd cop a feelmobile.
Yeah, that's right. A 74 Monte Carlo, cherry red with beige leatherette interior and a 327 under the hood.
Leatherette?
And that's not all. Chrome rims,
dual exhaust, AM/FM, 8-track.
What's leatherette?
I had a date with Brenda McKenzie,
At a drive-in, if you catch my drift?
My brakes were worn, so that day I took my car to Logan's shop.
Later, I found out he never even touched them. He was too busy restoring his 64 Caddy, his pride and joy. So Brenda wound up at the drive-in with Mark Dindleglass doing God knows what. And because of Logan, I lost my wheels. He still charged me $60. Can you believe that?
Boys and their cars. So, in the game, brake fluid stops Logan because he never fixed your brakes.
You don't understand. You don't understand how many hours, how many crappy summer jobs I worked to save for that car. My entire net worth was wrapped around a post.
Ending any chance you had of being wrapped around Brenda McKenzie. I understand perfectly.
Must be bolted from inside.
Aww. Hey, Peter, open up.
Peter!
Hey. So it's the hottest day in, what, like 5 centuries? And that is when my AC dies. You know, I'm trying to find a repairman anywhere within like 6 months of a heat wave, right? So I figure, why not just stay at the lab?
Hey, Peter.
I really don't need an explanation, but we're in play. It's the mechanic.
Oh, well, then you probably want the game tape. Well, okay. Tell you what, why don't I just run in there and get the tape, and that way the two of you guys can watch it in the privacy and comfort of your own home. Or homes, you know, depending on where you watch it.
But...
I figure the less time we spend talking about it, right, the more time you guys can have to stop the guy. Am I right or am I right? Don't give me... It's a new style, very hip, right now.
Your fly is open.
Oh, thank you.
Now, in the game, Logan is banished to a world in which private cars have been outlawed, rendering him obsolete. So to get his revenge, he turns his 64 Caddy into a death car and sets out to destroy public transportation. Now, the key to this level is the 64 Caddy. If we can stop Logan from stealing one, we win the level.
Is that an exploding dollar sign?
The one that shot out of the calculator?
Yes, Gus, that one.
See, that's Logan's estimate in the form of an electric charge. It causes a heart attack, get it? Well, on the plus side, it's not an automatic kill. With CPR, you're as good as new.
You're a merciful god, Gus.
So, all we have to do is figure out which caddy Logan's going after and stop him.
There, right there, that's gotta be it.
No.
Vista Motors on Breakheart Street. Like you were brokenhearted when you crashed your car?
It wasn't my heart that was broken, it was my car. Besides, who said it had to be for sale? Johnny Silver. He was the coolest private eye on television, and his silver rocket was a tricked-out 64 Caddy. And they're at Bachman Beach.
Bachman Turner Overdrive.
Richard Bachman was Stephen King's pen name, and Stephen King wrote Christine about a death car from hell. It's perfect.
I'm not even gonna try anymore.
Brake fluid, that'll hurt the car mechanic. Though, if you really want to do some damage, don't forget to bring a mirror. Mind if I come in? It's hot as hell out here.
Presenting a very special hour of television.
This woman is claiming that she has had a conversation with the Virgin Mary, whose face appears on the garage door.
An hour of intense drama.
They're gonna operate tomorrow evening.
An hour when anything can happen.
I'm so scared.
Even a anchorwoman Sherry Beck must make the ultimate leap of faith. The show is Live Shot, coming up next on UPN.
Here it goes.
Soda, OJ, Purple Stuff.
3D, yeah. Okay.
Tastes like orange, tangerine, and lime.
Some healthy junk, too.
Yeah. Hey, good start.
Hey, way to go, Mom.
Sunny Delight, the good stuff kids go for.
We wouldn't want Jackal and the mechanic to finish the death car, now would we?
What are you talking about?
Don't you think that Hormone Boy there should be a part of this?
Mm-hmm. Part of what?
Villain, the car mechanic. Weapon, calculator that shoots estimates, causing heart attack. First move, steel tires. That's directly from your game notes, Gus.
Well, I think the key word here is game.
Yeah? And I think there are a couple of nutballs running around playing this game for real. Nutballs like you, for instance.
That's ridiculous.
Is it? Well, then maybe you can explain why events matching at least five levels of Gus's game have occurred in the Los Angeles streets during the last 6 months.
Simple. Gus?
A freak accident brought all the game characters to life, and now they're out to destroy the world.
When was the last time you had your urine tested?
We don't have to stand here and be insulted.
Oh, no? Where do you usually go?
There's a heat wave. We're going to the beach.
Oh, yeah? You gonna have a water fight?
Is that illegal?
No, not at all. Mine? Brake fluid. Boy, that brings back memories, huh? Summer at Grandma's house, the slip and slide, the hot dogs, those wacky brake fluid fights. Well, folks, those days are over. And so is your freedom, unless you start cooperating.
I've been completely honest with you. I don't know what else I can tell you.
I'll make you a deal, Gus. You give me the names of the wackos who think they're Jackal and Mechanic, and I'll write those names down.
I can't help you.
Your story is unraveling. It's only a matter of time before it falls completely apart. Here. And say hello to Peter for me.
What did he mean about the mirrors? He said if you want to do some serious damage, don't forget the mirrors.
Well, it's how Logan is destroyed. After how he lied to me about fixing my brakes, I didn't know how he could look himself in the mirror. So in the game, he can't.
His reflection destroys him. Shouldn't be too difficult.
Did you hear something?
When I was a kid, all I wanted in life was to be Johnny Silver and fight evil in a silver rocket.
Look at you now, Gus. Fighting evil with brake fluid and mirrors. Dreams do come true. I never saw Johnny Silver. How long did it run for?
Half a season. Go figure television. They canceled Johnny, but Urkel stays on forever. Okay, take off your shirt.
Excuse me?
You stick out. Take off your shirt.
I'm not taking off my shirt, Gus.
Come on, what's the big deal? Nobody can tell the difference between a black bra and a bikini top anyway.
How do you know I'm wearing a black bra? You watch me get dressed. What are you, 14?
When a woman's getting dressed, all guys are 14. That's common knowledge. Well, at least let me put on some suntan lotion on your legs. I won't enjoy it, I swear.
You're enjoying this.
I'm not.
You said you wouldn't.
I swear I'm not. I find this revolting.
Liar.
Got the car.
Good look. You're finished.
Thanks for rubbing it in.
Oh, Johnny Silver?
I was. Young lady, I said I'd drive up in the car. I never agreed to any stunts. This piece of junk could barely steer 20 years ago.
Couldn't? I can't believe how Johnny Silver's let himself go.
People change, Gus. You seen Dan Aykroyd lately? Wait a minute. If Logan's not here, I'll bet he's at Vista Motors.
A customer brings his own mechanic. It's got to be a hard sell. Or a hardcore psycho who thinks he's a villain in a computer game.
Interesting career move, detective. Tell me, is used car salesman a step up or a step down?
Gee, it's kind of hard to say. Benefits aren't as good, but coffee's better.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll hit Logan with the brake fluid. When he turns, you shove the mirror in his face.
Good idea. They only get in the way. Well, now all you need is some new tires. Of course, you've already taken care of that, haven't you?
This heap's gonna need a lot of work.
I need to ask you boys a couple of questions. Like your whereabouts this morning around 7:30?
You right.
Yeah, right. Is that downtown?
Detective Dawn. I'm beginning to find your antics quite tiring.
Really? Well, gosh, then you're gonna hate this, because I'm gonna take you and Mr. Happy right there and run you into jail. Then I'm gonna slap your white suited ass into a chair and leave it there till I find out everything I need to know about this game, who's playing it, and who's going up on murder charges. This is not a joke, my friend.
No. Detective Dawn, it most certainly is not a joke. And I am most certainly not your friend.
Go, ladies. Give you a ride down to the loony bin. I want you to miss nap time.
Mr. Logan, have you got any kind of an estimate how long Detective Dawn is going to live?
Yeah, I hope that isn't the kind of taser that breaks when you drop it on the ground and kick it over to me.
Was that a squirt gun filled with brake fluid?
No. It happens to be a 38. The bullet in every chamber.
That's a relief.
Gets any enjoyment out of life. Sometimes I think I'm the only guy in town who knows how to party.
Ah. One, two, three, four, five, go.
This is
a competition, the only one in the world where killing your opponent is not
front against enormous. The punch, capable of knocking a man out in one-tenth of a second. The kick, clocked at 72 miles per hour. What would kill most men is going to make him a legend. Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Don't try to stop me.
The incredible true story of the only American ever to win. Bloodsport.
Thursday night at 8 on UPN 34 WTVX.
All this week, All American Male seeks swimming lessons from sexy, free-spirited lifeguard.
Yeah, this kind of offer doesn't come around every day.
Able to cool down their hot summer days.
You know, you're exquisitely beautiful when you're angry.
And heat up their cold winter nights.
I can easily fall in love with you.
It's Pamela Anderson to the rescue.
Where have you been all my life?
Actually, right out there.
Desperately seeking CJ Week on Baywatch.
It's on UPN 34 WTVX.
Your first time as a junior achievement elementary school volunteer can be a little scary, but very satisfying. Call us about volunteering. We'll supply you with training for this new program, and the kids will supply plenty of motivation.
Overhaul. The design is all wrong.
Well, what do you expect? Fools have been using it for delicate surgery instead of massive destruction.
Hey, what the hell are you doing with that?
Honestly, Mr. Logan is building a death car, and this laser comes standard.
You think that's funny? That piece of equipment's worth $75,000.
Really? Mr. Logan, an estimate, please, on what you think it's worth to us. Is there a doctor in the house?
I don't
Dorn know they'd be here.
Because the dealership is on Breakheart Street and your heart was broken.
Charles Bronson was in Breakheart Pass. Yes,
sir, please.
And Charles Bronson starred in The Mechanic. See?
You were lucky.
He's good.
You know, just because you guys saved my life doesn't mean you're off the hook.
Sir, please, put this on.
We're in big trouble.
I know. Charles Bronson was so obvious. How could I miss it?
Dorn's gonna send us to jail, probably forever, and you're upset because he plays the game better than you?
If I missed this last move, how can I be sure I won't miss the next one?
What is the next one?
Now there's a car that makes a statement. And tomorrow, following its historic drive of destruction, the death car will go on permanent display in the Jack-O-Land Museum of Terror. I wish he'd leave me in peace.
movie needs now are the stereo speakers. He gets those from a drive-in tonight.
Do we know which one?
No. I just programmed the movie to be a sequel. On my date with Brenda, we were supposed to see Police Academy 3.
You've always loved the classics.
Well, maybe I should call Dorn, ask him where Logan's gonna be.
This game is you. You'll figure out the right move.
Peter.
Hang on, baby, all right? I just got some movie sequels to find here.
Peter?
Hmm?
Have you ever seen Behind the Green Door 3?
No, I haven't. But I understand the original had some marvelous performances.
Do they ever stop? It's just not human.
Oh, hey. Hey, guys, I got the list right here. Hang on. Jump off. Oh,
you scientists are all alike. What you want to do is always more important.
Just give me 1 minute, okay? And then we can do that thing you like with the, you know.
Are you sure? If you like, we can wait until after the carnage.
He's just cranky because he missed a game move and lost the death car.
It wasn't Breakheart Street? Man, I was sure the Charles Bronson connection was a slam dunk.
Only two places.
Look, man, I checked the phone books, I checked the movie listings, everything, and those are the only two drive-ins that are showing sequels.
All right. This is good, okay? We can split up this way, and we can cover both of them.
See, I sort of promised I'd do something.
Oh, the thing with the, you know.
Okay, fine. I will cover the drive-in.
What?
Look, I could use a little recharging anyway, right?
Thanks.
Gus, I mean, do you think that just because Terry is constantly all over me, do you think that makes me happy?
Ecstatic.
Yeah, well, that's me.
Remember, folks, the concession stand is still open, featuring
hot, fresh, buttered popcorn,
ice-cold soda pops,
your favorite candy,
and hot dogs.
So hurry up and get your favorite treat.
The movie starts in 5 minutes.
What's playing?
Ace Ventura, When Nature Calls.
Gee, I hope it's as sophisticated as the original. Are you sure this is the right drive?
Ace is a comedy. Police Academy was a comedy. This is the place.
Okay.
Incredible odds.
How that voice sounds familiar. Is that the submarine guy from Disneyland?
His enemy was beyond contempt. Only one man had the brilliance and the power to bring him to his knees. And that man called upon the car mechanic. Ross Logan is the car mechanic, coming much sooner than you think.
They cheer at that.
They're here, Gus. They're here and they're taunting us.
Unless they're not here. Unless they're at the other drive-in and they're taunting us.
You said they'd be here.
This is the comedy. They have to be here. They're definitely here.
All right, then.
Unless they're there.
Gus!
I'm sorry. I was wrong about Bachman Beach. Maybe I'm wrong about this,
too.
All right.
Listen. Your instinct said that they would be here, so they'll be here. And we'll just wait and be ready. God, is everyone making out?
I guess we should too.
So we don't stick out. Okay, ready? Begin.
Estimate on that door.
Good try it, kid. Mr. Logan's aim is almost perfect from inside 2 inches. Hey, you like the trailer?
My feeling is there's too much violence in movies these days.
It's time to put it back where it belongs.
In real life.
Presenting a...
And tomorrow night, and maybe the next night, and the following day, and the next day, and on into that evening. The Copper Top. No battery is stronger, longer.
Kudos alert in Sector 13. Lunch.
Great chocolate taste.
Wholesome oats and grains.
Nice work.
Kudos. All systems go.
Roger, copy.
Mind if I join you? The girl who took her shirt off is just about to get hit by a flying chainsaw.
Oh, part always gives me the heebie-jeebies.
Hey, a mirror. What's this for?
What? I'm a vain guy, okay? What are you doing here anyway? I thought you were in the hospital.
Check myself out. I'm fine. Well, I do pick up an oldie station and a couple of fillings. So, there's Jackal, the mechanic. Well, Gus, for that matter, where's he parked?
Gus isn't here. I don't know where he is.
You like to play games, Peter? I have one for you. It's called Beat the Suspect. What happens is I ask you a question, and then while you try to think about how to avoid answering me, I think about where I can hit you where it won't be readily visible.
Look, if you're gonna threaten me... Well, that pretty much works.
You'll be a fine contestant. Now, for your new and improved answer?
He and Lauren are at the other drive-in.
Why? I mean, Gus's note said that it had to be a sequel. This is Flesh Eaters 3. There's no number in Ace Ventura.
Yeah, well, if you'd like to lodge a rules protest, maybe you ought to talk to Gus.
Something must have happened by now. Come on, take my car.
Oh, great.
There's the car.
What the hell happened to the door?
Oh, man.
Maybe they went over to the snack bar.
Maybe they were really hungry. Peter. Enough with this, huh? I mean, this game started out as a fun little hobby, but now you've got psychotics role-playing for real.
Thank you. I'm aware of that.
Yeah, well, are you aware of just how dangerous this nutcase who thinks he's Jackal really is? He doesn't have a sane bone in his body. And neither do you if you think he's going to lay down for a brake fluid and mirrors just because the game rules say he should.
Look, there's still some things that you don't understand.
You're wrong. There's only two. Why caterpillars turn into butterflies and how the commish stayed on the air for four seasons.
Why do you do that? Why do you take those sudden mental detours?
Don't ask me that. I'm not having a conversation. This is an interrogation. Completely different, except for the last five letters. Now, what's the mechanic's next move? Gus's game notes don't have it.
That's it. There is no next move. Tomorrow morning, he uses the death card to destroy some form of public transportation.
Well, that's great. Fine. And all we gotta do is find out where and when.
You know what the problem is? The problem is that we don't know what we're doing. I mean, we're looking at train schedules. We're playing what train station rhymes with Jackal. But basically, we don't have a clue as to what we're doing. We need Gus.
Okay. Let's go ask him. Where is he? Well, he's not here, is he, Peter? But we've still got a disaster waiting to happen, so let's get back to work, shall we?
I'm gonna look at the tape again.
behind right there.
Yeah, freeze it right there. Can you, zoom in on that black and white blurry thing?
Mm-hmm, no problem.
Didn't you say that Gus sometimes uses real locations in his game? Is that right?
That is right.
Hello? Yeah, I'm calling about that acreage you have listed for sale. Oh, really? You sold it 2 years ago, huh? Gee. I wonder, can you just tell me where it is so I could maybe drive by and think of what might have been? Great.
Man, you are good.
I know what you two are thinking. This is going to be better than that day at Yankee Stadium, and you're just proud to be part of it.
Trust me, Jackal. It's not what I'm thinking.
Oh, don't be such a grump. Your demise had to happen sooner or later, so just enjoy it. Now, I need your advice. Do you think over there is far enough away? I'm worried I might get someone on me.
Ow.
Giving free bats to 50,000 beer-drinking New Yorkers. a stroke of genius.
Tied to a railroad crossing, Gus. What is this, your homage to Dudley Do-Right?
How are you coming with the ropes?
I can barely move. Ouch. What are we gonna do?
I don't know. This is a perfect example of a cop never being around when you need one.
Gus, do you hear that?
I can hear it.
Gus, what's gonna happen?
First, the train's gonna run over us, and then Logan's gonna blow up the train. Well, you asked.
Oh! I'm sorry we didn't make love one last time.
Don't give up. We still have something to look forward to. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What happened? Oh. What happened with what? Oh.
With my serious dandruff, I'll try anything. Dinner?
Shave this.
If you can grow it, we can shave it. The newest Remington Triple Foil. The only shaver with three micro screens now has a 50% greater cutting rate with a more powerful motor and three flexible foils for those hard-to-shave places on hard-to-shave faces. So make it this smooth, this comfortable, and this close. The new Remington Triple Foil. If you can grow it, we can shave it.
Enjoy the bold scent of Mountain Spring Downy.
So bold, you'll love it. The freshness of it.
And now, Mountain Spring Downy Dryer.
On Springer.
Throw away the ice, close the freezer door, break out the soup, because this heat wave is over, folks. 5 days of record temperatures has set this city on edge.
When hit with a stream of brake fluid, the suspect's back began smoking.
That is correct. And there are people, Captain, who are out there still playing this game for real.
Look, Tom, you're recovering from a recent heart attack.
Very slight, caused by the suspect's calculator. It had a taser in it.
Tom, if I submit this report, then I've also got to nominate you for a complete psychological workup.
Oh, come on now. You saw the car with the laser.
It was bizarre, but it was an isolated incident.
It was not an isolated incident. There are at least half a dozen other incidents that I can connect to the game. And I guarantee you there are more out there. I haven't found them yet, that's all.
Okay. Print out what you got and get it on my desk, but it better be solid.
Wiped out Dorn's report. I eliminated his notes on the game, and I signed him up for 6 different CD clubs. But guy's gotta have some fun, right? Man, it's freezing in here. I'm gonna turn off the air.
So, let's take a little walk down memory lane, shall we?
Let's go.
Train tracks, us tied to them. Mm-hmm. Lives hanging in the balance. Certain things were said.
Like, for instance, when I said I wished that we'd made love one last time.
You know, I forgot about that particular one. But yes, you did say that.
Well, listen, Gus. I think that we should wait until all this game stuff is over. So we can see if any of what we think we've been feeling is real.
Or if it was just the heat.
Or the circumstances.
Or the thought of that tiny black dress I bought you for my birthday.
Okay.
Your loss.
You wish.
No way.
I'm sure.
On
the next deadly games, AC meets DC. Washington, D.C., that is. The nation's capital is Jackal's next target.
He's going to destroy the Supreme Court.
He's the leader of the most shocking gang of video game thugs that ever walked off the screen. And that includes this week's cybervillain, a lawyer whose charges are outrageous.
She's only got 10,000 volts.
Will our hero sock it to her or get fried in the process?
Jump!
Christopher Lloyd stars in explosive all-new Deadly Games next Tuesday on UPN.
Coming up next, it's a live shot you don't want to miss. A woman's life is on the line, and to survive, she has to make the ultimate leap of faith. It's a special episode that will make you a believer, too. An all-new live shot coming up next.